An abandoned vacation home spent a decade taking on legends, but now it's taking on water. The mysterious Cape Romano Dome home was completed in 1981 on land, but today it stands in 7 feet of water. Kristen Clark has the story on this mysterious Southwest Florida gem that's slowly sinking.
Just 6 miles south of Marco Island, you'll see the world-famous Cape Romano Domes, built by a man in 1979. Now everyone comes from all over just to see them.
Many people wonder, what are these odd dome-shaped structures off the coast of Marco Island? Well, it used to be a house made of 6 interconnecting domes built by former oil producer Bob Lee.
It was a 3-bedroom, 3-bath house, 2,400 square foot that was completely off the grid. That sat actually a quarter mile inland when it was completed.
It was a house unlike anything else at the time, built to be almost completely self-sustaining.
He had a gutter system that went around the base so that when it rained, it would trickle on all sides, get caught in that gutter, and then sent to a 23,000-gallon cistern. And that's how he got his drinking water.
And its dome shape played a crucial role in its design.
There was no sharp corners for the wind to catch on, and it would roll right around the structure.
The dome home also had solar panels to generate energy. His family said that on sunny days, they could do anything. But when it was cloudy, they had to conserve energy and take quick showers so that there was enough power to get them through the day.
Now, we lived in the property until about 1992. That's when Hurricane Andrew came across the coast, blew out the windows, caused massive water damage, and he ended up abandoning the property about 2 years later.
They won't be there forever.
During Hurricane Andrew, passages opened up along the coast, which has increased the coastal current, which has caused sand to erode at a lot greater of a pace.
But as of right now, you can still discover Florida's mysterious dome home before it sinks into the sea.
2 of these domes have already fallen down, but they still have 4 more left if you want to come down to Marco Island to check them out.
In Marco Island, Kristen Clark, NBC2.